This video will provide an overview of the Radioline PLC Modbus RTU mode, which allows you to read and write I/O signals by using the Modbus RTU protocol. An example of an application for PLC Modbus RTU mode would be if many sensors at several remote stations need to be monitored from a central control station. PLC Modbus RTU mode allows the user to integrate the I/O signals directly into the existing control system by using a communication protocol. This saves hardware costs and installation time spent on wiring to the controller. In this mode, the complete Radioline network works as a Modbus slave. The process data of all I/O modules installed in the Radioline network are stored in a central Modbus table in the Radioline master. One wireless network can contain up to 99 I/O modules. If more I/O modules are needed, you can simply install additional Radioline masters or use the PLC Modbus RTU dual mode. The I/O data is converted to the Modbus protocol and stored in registers based on the I/O map address of the I/O module. Each I/O module in the network requires a unique I/O map address. This unique address provides the register offset for the data and allows the controller to access the individual I/O values. This demo setup includes a wireless master, which is working as a Modbus slave connected to the notebook via a serial interface. A radio slave station with a digital input module and a digital output module, both connected via the DIN rail connector. The switch module is only used to simulate the digital inputs. The I/O modules have a unique I/O map address. A duplicate assignment of the I/O map address is not permitted unless several output modules need to receive the same command. The Modbus Pole software is used as a Modbus master on a notebook. The wireless modules must be configured with the SciConf software. The devices are already pre-configured in this demo setup. The Radioline master with RAD ID 01 gets an adjustable Modbus slave address, in this setup 01. The serial interface parameters in Modbus Pole and the wireless master must be identical. As soon as the demo setup is supplied with power, the radio connection will automatically build up within a few seconds. The red air LED on the radio module flashes until the respective I/O modules have been addressed via Modbus communication. The flashing error LED results from a watchdog contained in the radio master. This watchdog monitors the Modbus communication and is triggered with each correctly received Modbus telegram. The watchdog timeout can be set between 200 milliseconds and 65 seconds. With the Modbus Pole software, a Modbus communication to the radio master is now established. If the serial cable is connected and the interface parameters are set correctly, the RX and TX LEDs will flash on the Radioline master. Since there is Modbus communication present, the red error LEDs on the radio modules will turn off. The update time of the central Modbus register in the radio master can vary depending on the frequency band, network size, and signal quality of the radio links. This must be considered in the controller to make sure up-to-date data is being read. If the white thumb wheel of an input module is set to the I/O map address 02, the process data is stored in the register with the address 30021. To address an input module, Modbus function code 04 is used to read the register. Please note that the Modbus protocol differentiates between register number 0-based and register address 1-based. Depending on the method used, the register address may differ by 1. The address range is already defined by the function code 04, so we only need to enter the register 21 to read the digital inputs. By setting the digital inputs DI1 to DI4, the binary register values change from 0 to 1. If the white thumb wheel of an output module is set to the I/O map address 03, the process data is stored in the register with the address 40031. To address an output module, Modbus function code 16 is used to write the register. With function code 03, you can read back the status of the output registers. The red error LED on the digital output module will flash until the output register is written for the first time. Function code 16, the register address 31, is now addressed by Modbus Pole to activate the digital output DO1. The enabled output is seen by the status LED on the I/O module. Now you can see the red error LED on the output module has stopped flashing. The current status of the output can be read back via the function code 03. If several I/O modules are to be read by a controller, it should be noted that each I/O module uses 10 words. Therefore, a range of Modbus addresses can be read. For example, the process data of four I/O modules of the same type with the I/O map addresses 01, 02, 03, and 04 can be read in one request. In this case, an address area with 40 words, Modbus register addresses 11 to 41, can be read. The Modbus table also provides status and diagnostic parameters of the individual radio stations, such as the RSSI values, also known as signal strength of the respective radio stations. The RSSI values of all wireless modules in the network are stored in the address range 35001 to 35250. For example, to read out the signal strength of the radio station with the RAD ID 02, register 5002 must be read. The register indicates the signal strength in dB. When a wireless station is disconnected from the network, the value 255 is displayed. This allows a Modbus controller to monitor the complete wireless network. For the I/O integration in Siemens TIA Portal or PCWorks, we offer corresponding function modules. These are available free of charge on the Phoenix Contact homepage in the download area of the radio line modules. An inline or axial line, Profibus or Profinet BK, is only required for the interface conversion from Modbus to Profibus or Profinet. For more information regarding Radioline, please contact Technical Service at 800-322-3225.